Hi, I'm Deet James, hunting heritage biologist for the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission. One of the goals of the commission and of our hunting heritage program is to continually increase access for hunters and other outdoor recreationists. One of the ways we've done that is through acquiring, with the help of the North Carolina Handicapped Sportsman, Huntmaster hunting units.
These lifts for our disabled sportsmen will be available for organized special needs hunts in each of our 9 districts.
Today we plan to show you how to operate the lift. We also recommend that you download the manual, which is available on our website at www.ncwildlife.org before attempting to use the Huntmaster. Remember, it is important to use the lift on relatively flat ground, no sloping or uneven terrain where it might tip over. It is also important to remember that the housing unit on the lift ascends to an eye level height of about 20 feet.
Do not deploy the unit under power lines, electrical cables, or communications wires. Keep in mind that the Huntmaster does not follow a straight up and down path, so do not use within 50 feet of any wires. In addition, do not use the Huntmaster in water or if the ground is wet or swampy after rainy conditions. Soft, unstable ground may affect the load-bearing capacity. Remember to give the Huntmaster a visual inspection for loose parts, severed cables, and oil leaks. Do not use the unit if it has irreparable problems. The first step in using the Huntmaster unit is uncoupling it from the towing vehicle. First, using the wheel chocks provided, block one wheel using both blocks, forward and rearward of the tire, on either side of the unit. First, remember to disconnect the electrical plug and then remove the safety chains. Remove the safety pin or lock, then return to the tongue-mounted stabilizer, rotate it, and replace the pin. Then lift up on the safety ball latch and return to the tongue-mounted stabilizer and rotate the handle clockwise until the ball coupler has been raised off the towing ball. Be sure it is fully disconnected from the towing vehicle. Finally, it is important to remember to drive the towing vehicle away from the Huntmaster before proceeding to stabilize the unit. Stabilizing the Huntmaster unit is one of the most important parts of setup. It ensures the user that the lift does not tip over or become unsteady during use. It is important to fully extend the outriggers during use for maximum safety and stability. Do not attempt to elevate the unit until all outriggers have been properly deployed. Stabilizer jack bases have a small surface area. Wooden boards or planks can be utilized under stabilizer jack bases if needed on relatively soft ground. Pull up on the spring-loaded outrigger pins and extend outriggers until they stop and click into place. Remove the individual stabilizer jacks from their stored location and attach to each outrigger. Rotate the jack handle until the stabilizer bases are in firm contact with the ground. Note, it is a good idea to attach each stabilizer jack in pairs. Tongue end of trailer first, then rear end of trailer. Return to the rear outriggers and repeat the process. It is best to always use two people to extend the outriggers. Remember to deploy the mid-trailer stabilizer jacks as well. including the tongue-mounted stabilizer jack, the Huntmaster has 7 stabilizer jacks in all. Final leveling should be done with the bubble level found on the front of the trailer frame. The Huntmaster lift is equipped with a solar panel to provide auxiliary power to the unit. You will find it secured in a storage box in the housing unit. Remove it from the box and bring it to the tongue end of the trailer, where you will find a mounting post for the solar panel. To install, place the panel on the mounting post, secure the tightening knob, and connect the wire. Remember to use 2 people when preparing to lift. First, connect the battery power by turning the green power connection knob clockwise. Locate the manual control button in the battery and pump compartment at the tongue end of the trailer. Push the manual control button to raise the housing unit enough so the trailer tailgate clears the housing unit brackets. Then the assisting person can remove the holding brace that secures the trailer tailgate, lowering it toward the tongue of the trailer, and then reattach the holding brace and pin. Finally, using the down button, lower the hunting compartment to the ground and prepare to enter. To unlock, insert the key and turn it counterclockwise to the noon position and then return to the 3 o'clock position. To lock, insert the key and turn it clockwise to the 6 o'clock position and return to the 3 o'clock position. To lower the seat, release the nylon strap securing the seat to the wall and fold it down.